All good? Test, test. Test, test. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm assuming you can hear. My name is Ian Liversidge. I'm the principal of Garibaldi Secondary School. I've been here for 5 years. If we add in COVID, I don't know if that makes it more time or less. One of the things we've been working on this year is trying to make sure that we complete kind of the resurrection of some of the programs and some of the quality that we've had at this school. Just to give you a highlight of some of the things that have happened the last month or so at our school. We've had about 40 kids do tests that if they score high enough, and most will give them university credit in up to 6 courses. That's part of our International Baccalaureate IB program. It's pretty amazing that a collection of kids can leave a public school in BC and advance into second year university in a variety of courses or a single course, be that in Canada, the United States, or elsewhere, because our kids are heading all over the world. We have next week, the 20th and 23rd, week after next, we have a musical theater production. This is the first time in a long time the grads have elected to run their own musical theater production with, of course, teacher support, doing an extra one. It turns out the majority of our grads from the theater program are choosing to progress to colleges and university doing theater, so that's a testament to the outstanding leadership there. We've had our grad festivities. We'll have our grad walking across the stage event. Our grad class this year will be about 190. To me, the rubber meets the road in graduation rates. The number of kids we welcome in the door in grade 8 versus the number that we are getting out. I am deeply concerned about only 2 of 190 plus of our grads. That's a grad rate that's about 99%. In case you're wondering, the province grad rate is below 80. So that means your kids are in a place of care and a place where people take attention and a place where we work to keep the cracks really, really small. One of the ways we keep the cracks small is by having a community with outstanding programs. Behind me is the beginning of the journey that is banned. I'm also an uncle. I have a nephew that went through this program for 5 years and right now is one of the top French horn players in the UBC Concert Orchestra program. Mr. Kirkpatrick will back me up a little bit on that. Yes, he's pretty good. Who? Beaner, Braden. My nephew, just say yes.
Yes.
Yes, okay. The experience of band is a journey, and it's a little bit like high school. You come in and you're trying to figure it out. You're trying to find your place. You're trying to find your rhythm. You're trying to find everything within the sequence. But we see the journey over 5 years where everybody begins to come together. So if you're here and you're watching this, the beginning of the grade 8, soon to be grade 8 experience, I encourage you to make sure you're staying till the end of the performance this evening, because it finishes with a jazz band, which includes a high number of grade 12s who have spent 5 years developing, working their craft. And I would suggest that they have found their rhythm. They have found their symbiotic experience. And it makes for a wonderful outcome. I'm stalling for you, dude. So without further ado, last thing, it's important to recognize that everything we do at our school is on the traditional and unceded territories of the Catesy and Kwantlen First Nations. Adding to that, the land that you're sitting on right now was actually cleared by a Japanese family. This land was expropriated in World War II. And then bought back other ways. The indigenous people that were here were down at the water, etc. This was, of course, their land. We're meeting underneath the two mountains, and the two mountains in the Catesy culture are told to me to be called the grandfathers. So enjoy this evening. Celebrate, recognize the greatness that is beginning and the greatness that will finish, and as well the adults who are responsible. So have a good evening. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Liversidge. Hi, everybody. I'm Mr. Kirkpatrick, Mr. KP, that guy, whatever they call me at home, that's fine. Up front, right in front of you, we have a combination of the elementary band, which is grade 6-7s. They meet after school twice a week. And then the grade 8 band that started with me at the beginning of February. So they both started at different times, but are almost exactly in the same spot in their progression now. And it's easier to play with numbers, right, guys? So we combine them so you can hear the full force of this. So first we're going to play a piece called Tadpoles. If you look really closely in the back, you'll actually hear a frog croaking. I'm not making that up. And the second piece is called Shadowfire. I don't have to say much about it because the song speaks for itself. So Tadpoles and Shadowfire.
Thank you.
Okay, hello, thank you. So that was the elementary band plus the grade eights. Can I get one more round of applause for the elementary kids that are just going out into the audience? Like I said, mostly grade six and seven right there. We're going to do a quick set change, so we're going to combine both of our grade eight classes now. So most of these kids met at, they're in all classes together, obviously. But the big thing that they met together was our retreat out to Loon Lake in March. I think it was March. I don't remember. And so Miss Bell's class started in September because we're in semesters, and then my class started at the beginning of February. And so they're almost caught up to each other in terms of what they've learned. My class still has about another 3 weeks worth of school, but... So today we're going to play three pieces for you with this group, because why not? So the first tune we're going to play for you is a piece called Ranting and Roaring. So this is it's technically a Newfoundland piece, which is actually stolen from a Welsh piece. And it's one of those, you know those old, sailing songs, sea shanties? It's very much like that. It starts with some bagpipey drones, it gets faster and crazy. And I should keep stalling. Okay, and the second piece we're going to play for you is a piece called Arctic Wars. And it's actually about, it's March of the Penguins. So the Penguin Army, a rise of the Penguin Army. So it starts off mysterious and then gets loud and angry. Kind of like when they wake up in the morning, right? And then the third piece we have for you is one I'm sure you'll recognize. It's Pirates of the Caribbean. Not the Caribbean, it's Caribbean. Thank you. So I hope you recognize that one. That's definitely the hardest one, and one that would not only do with the grade eight band. It's just a little bit too hard, but these guys are like, no, KP, we have to do it. I'm like, okay, I can't fight off 19 of you at once, and now there's 40 of them, okay? I think I'm done stalling. Ms. Bell, can I go? Are they ready?
Maybe.
Okay, I got the maybe. Give me 7 seconds, and I'll let you know.
Best to go around on this side here. Okay. Make sure you can hear trombones, left hand saxophone, the horn.
Okay. And our last number, if you like your promise, is going to be Pirates. I see a lot of people doing, if you guys want to come up and take pictures and stuff, totally do it. This is chill. I mean, look at what we're wearing. So if you want to do pictures of your kids and stuff, I'll also point out the live stream is up, slash if you want to watch it later on YouTube and get some zoom-ins and stuff, Tim's doing a great job of catching the back of my head, I'm sure. So you can also get that too, but please, if you want pictures, come up and take pictures, please, by all means. Last piece, if they're ready, is Pirates of the Caribbean. Okay, so while they're getting seated, this is our junior jazz band. So mostly grade 9s and 10s, a couple of grade 8s mixed in there. This group's been playing all year. We meet, my brain. When do we have class? See, their brains are dead too. We meet Mondays after school and Tuesdays during flex. So we got two tunes for you today. Nice shoes, dude. Oh man, he's got flamingo socks and I've got a flamingo shirt. I'm gonna need those socks. The first tune I'm going to play for you is a tune called Filling In for the Count. It's a classic jazz tune. It's a take on a classic jazz tune, I should say. Nice and easy listening, smooth jazz, basically. And the second one is a tune that I'm sure you already recognize from the program. I've been trying to get them not to play it, but they love it. So Louie Louie is going to be our second chart for the evening. This is the Junior Jazz Band. Thank you. Hey, this is Louie Louie. They don't really need me. I'm just going to get him started. Okay, so while they're getting organized, this next one we actually have is a student-led group. So up front there in the fabulous shirt. Isn't it a fabulous shirt? I think so. Sorry, Ethan, I had to. This is Ethan. He's in grade 11. He plays every single instrument under the sun, plus two. He lives in the band room, basically. He has lived in the band room since grade 5. Yeah, grade 5. Long before I got here. The group of them put this together. It's called Rise of the Storm or something? Rising Storm? Rise of the Storm. It's a cool piece. It's kind of video gamey. They loved it. Miss Bell and I had nothing to do with this other than being like, yeah, you can use the band room and stuff, I guess. I don't see why not. So I'll let them do the rest of the work. This is the Garibaldi Student Wind Ensemble. They're working on a better name. Their words, not mine.
desk is picking us up. You can move a bit forward, but we need to basically be, that's our monitor. Come on, close.
Test, test. Just as the vocal jazz is setting up, there was a fender bender in the parking lot. Honda, I believe, gray. License plate number JC8-81W. Yeah, JC8-81W, a Honda. Somebody has accidentally hit your vehicle, but I do have all their demographic information, and I'm just sitting over there. So. We can help to get that supported. Thank you.
Okay, over. Over. Like, get in here. In single file. Quickly, let's go. Quickly. Get in. You guys, look who has to get in, and then make it work.
Was that me or you? Okay.
Okay.
Just checking.
Guys, Sunny circling a little. It doesn't matter what you look like. This is being videoed. Forever and ever it will last.
Oh my god.
Hey, you guys. City of Stars is first.
Oh my god. Are we?
This is just. Yeah, yeah, that's good.
Ethan. Hello. Okay, so this is our vocal jazz crew. We didn't start vocal jazz this year until February-ish. Just because the first semester was too crazy and just didn't work out. So they've been working on some songs in the last couple months. The first song is on the program, City of Stars. And I'm not going to say this stuff until after because they're already nervous enough, yeah?
No, you're not nervous, you're perfect.
I'm terrified. Okay, team, I'm here for you. Don't make me stand in front of you. That's all. You good? Hey, don't look at the audience, look at me. Look at me. Hi. Okay, here we go. I think so.
Yes, all we're looking for is love.
Stars, and we had solos from Ethan and Aiden and Maisie over here. So let's give them a hand. And now for a song that gets stuck in my head like non-stop, this song. This is a song, excuse me, from Soul, a movie that came out a bit ago. It's not actually from Soul. It existed a long time before that, but this is It's All Right. It's All Right. Oh, yeah. All right. Richard, can you hear them? Are they close enough? Okay, good. We can't tell, so that's good. All right. Hey, team. It's all right. See?
Can you say it's all right?
It is all right.
I will. Is this okay? I can't remember where I had it. Is this about right for your view? it's me again. Oh,
all right, that was on me. Someone turned it up. This is your friendly reminder to go buy food. We have hot dogs, we've got veggie dogs, we got pop, we got chips, we got water, we got cotton candy. Anybody ever call it candy floss? I said that to the kids last week and they had no idea what I was talking about. I don't know where I got it from, but anyway, that's what we got over there. Chips, the combo's $5, everything else is $2 for everything. Please go buy food, if you're hungry or not. Buy me food, I'll take food. Richard's showing me a thing. Oh, on your programs, there's a QR code. Please give us all of your money. No, seriously, please, if you're interested, just, we do a lot of this by donation. This helps go toward the program to allow us to put things on. It helps us subsidize things like some of the trips that we go on, helps pay for the repairing of all the gear in the background, and, you know, just buying all the stuff that we need. I got a few more things. I don't think I have anything else to say. Yeah, I'm going to get there. Okay, so I'm going to hand this over to... I don't actually know your last name. Sergey Riga, and if you want to say a few things about who you are and why you're here and all the rest, just don't say anything bad about me, okay?
Hello. Hi, I'm Sergey Riga. This is the George Eliot Secondary School tour group. And last year at this time, I met Rebecca. She came with your school's band to our school. And I thought, wow, that'd be wonderful to come back and play for you guys here. So this is an awesome venue with beautiful mountains off in the distance. We're not going to take a lot of time because I know you're here to see your kids, not us. But we're going to do a couple of songs. And the first one that we're going to do was actually written by the guy that's standing on the conductor's podium. That's Marnu. He's a grade 11 student. And this is the first thing he's ever written. So let's hear it from Marnu. And it's actually pretty good. It's called Dastardly Deeds. I'll let you introduce your song.
Hi. That's on. Okay. It's called A Dastardly Tale, Evil's Origins, and the concept of the song is basically just following the plot of a villain from like a movie. You know, they're happy, something bad happens, now they're not happy anymore. That's about everything. What do I do with the mic afterward?
Oh, you think? Thank you. Good job, man. I'm gonna help.
One thing, every
We're going to finish off with a piece called Blue Ridge Saga. Thank you.
All right. We got a new piano amp, so we don't know how it works yet. So this is our senior jazz band. Still checking the piano. But senior jazz band is going to play a couple tunes for you. This first one features a couple of our students that I'm not going to introduce yet because they get all nervous about it. So I'll tell you who afterwards. This is called My Foolish Heart.
Thank you.
All right, and solos in that tune, the first one was Ethan on trombone over here. And Adam back there on flugel. And Marcus on clarinet. Good job. Okay, Senior Jazz is gonna play one more tune for you. This is called Gospel John. I don't have more to say than that. Gospel John, here we go.
Thank you.
check, 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 check. Quick reminder, there are lots of snacks and concessions, drinks over there. If you're hungry still or need a drink, mosey on over. They'll help you right out.
Once upon a time on a band trip to Fredericton, we had a student who had a birthday, and the day of her birthday, we sang happy birthday to her 18 times. It was kind of painful. She kind of regretted having birthday, but you all have these stickers on right now, yes? So the person on this sticker that you may not know or you may know, Aaron Reed, who's probably over there somewhere. It's okay, Aaron, I'm not going to make you come up. But Erin has been on her music parent committee for 10 years. Her son did not take 10 years to get through high school. She's just continued on for all that time after. She was, in fact, on that Fredericton trip with us. And she's decided that this year she's going to retire. Our deal, though, was that Erin would only retire when I retired, so I feel a little ripped off because I can't retire yet. So I don't know what the song is for Happy Retirement. But can we... I don't know if we can do 10 times, but can we right now just give Aaron a big, big, huge round of applause? This is number one. Ready? Go. And funny thing, we were trying to find a picture to put on this little sticker thing so you'd all know who she was when you went over to concession. But Tim and I, Tim, who is also on camera, who hasn't had a kid in our school for like for a few years. Anyway, Tim is also helping out tonight. So he was on Music Parent Committee too, but it's nice to be able to keep them going because they got experience.
Yeah,
Tim and I
graduated 2 years ago and she didn't have a kid in the band when he started.
That's true. There's still people over there that don't have kids in band, but they just keep going. So Tim and I were looking for a picture and we couldn't find one where Erin wasn't busy working. Because it was really hard to find her face for this sticker. I think her husband provided this picture. So she doesn't even know we're talking about her right now. We'll talk about her more. If you're at our Music Family's barbecue, our Music Family barbecue is next Friday. I haven't sent the email out. I'm sorry. I will get to it tomorrow. That barbecue is for just music students and families. We'll do something. Don't tell her. We'll do something there. Okay? So she wasn't listening, right? It's all good. Our first and last, actually, tune our grade 10 band is about to play for you is called Scattered Light. This song was a song that was actually very tricky to put together because just like Scattered Lights, the music is here and there and everywhere. And it was actually like a big puzzle to put this piece together. It was actually written in memoriam for a student not here, a school in the state somewhere, I can't remember which one. Anyway, it was commissioned for their band on behalf of this student. You'll hear a rhythm in this piece that repeats and repeats and repeats. Is that student's name, was it in Morse code? I believe that was the story. So it's Morse code for that student's name. This is Scattered Light.
So we did one applause for Aaron already, right? Can we do a second one? Okay, you guys, we're saying thank you to Aaron. Yay! Two. She still can't hear you. you, so it's okay. All right, so that's number two. You guys have to count with me, because at the barbecue, I'm going to forget what number we were at the concert, and then we have to carry on from there, all right? So this group is made up of our grade 10, 11, and 12s. This piece that we're about to do, we actually performed 3 weeks ago, I think it was. I don't even know. The weeks have been very, very full. At the Maple Ridge Concert Band concert. So we were guests, and we played this with them as a mass band piece. We really liked it, and we worked really hard on learning it, so we decided we'd do it again. So this is called Overture for Winds. There we go.
Thank you.
Okay, we're doing another switch. So our senior concert band is about to play a piece for you. And then, anyone out there that's playing in the mass band tune at the end, you have one more piece. It's a fairly long piece. One more piece, and then we're going to put a really, 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 really big band on the stage that has never played with each other before. And it's going to be great. So, if you're one of those people that's going to play in the next number after this, get ready, get your instruments, get everything ready so we're ready to roll, okay? So you know, once upon a time when we had this pandemic thing and we had plexiglass everywhere, this came in very handy because we actually are putting this on our music tonight so it doesn't blow away. But I have to thank Sandy, where are you? I can't remember her husband's name. I'm sorry. I just said Sandy Donaldson's husband cut all these for us so that we can use them tonight. So we should give him a round of applause. Thank you, Sandy Donaldson's husband. I can't remember your name right now. And hey, while you're at it, let's do one more round for Aaron. Are you ready? Can you make it really loud? Go, go, go. Okay. We are about to play a piece for you that these guys have kind of been bugging me about playing for a while. It's a great piece of music, but it's not the easiest piece of music. Once upon a time, this guy named Holst wrote a bunch of music, and he called it The Planets. This is one of the movements from The Planets called Jupiter. It's probably my favorite, actually, out of all of them. And our senior band's going to do it for you. So enjoy. Thank you. Okay, we are going to mass band now. Find a spot and make it happen, people. Grab a stand, grab a chair, grab whatever you need, and come on in, seniors. Thank you. Okay. Hey, guys. Where are our picture taker peoples? We definitely want to get pictures of this. So, we have a lot of flute players on stage right now. Flute players, can you just hold up your flute so we can see all the flute players? Holy man, right? How about clarinets? Clarinets, show us your army. Oh, there's more. All right. How about bass clarinets and bassoons and Barry saxes? Lift, if you can lift them, I don't know. It's hard, oh, that's a tuba, you're confused. Okay, so the tubas had to get in on that, right? All right, so now I'm a little scared. Okay, put them down, don't die. How about altos and tenor saxes? That's a lot of saxophone. All right, how about, okay, put them down. Trumpets. See, that's why I said don't lift them. Hey, shh, don't give it away. Okay, French horns. Yay, French horns, come on, yes. Okay, French horns, and I've missed people. Trombones. Oh, you could have been taller, but that's cool, all right. And baritones. Euphoniums, it's because some of my people played the other. Ethan, you should have been on euphonium, telling you. It's these kids that want to play every brass instrument, sorry. Percussion. Basses. Holy man. Thank you. Oboes. Yes. An English horn. Piccolo? Shh. No playing yet. Hey. You don't have to do Old MacDonald yet. It's okay. Do we have any? What did we say? Piccolo. Okay, that's all right. Violin. Violin. Where's violin? All right. I hope I didn't miss any. Oh my gosh, it's a lot of kids. So, we are about to play a song we've never played together. Do you think it'd be good? Oh, heck yeah, it'd be fine. So this song was chosen this year because... Hey, shh, don't give it away. This song was chosen this year because when our grade 12s... I would ask them to stand, but there's no way we can do that right now. When our grade 12s were in grade 8, this is a song they played in grade 8. And it's one of the songs they really liked in grade 8, and they're like, we should play it again. So we brought it back, and it's a mass band piece. We did something similar another year. I can't remember what the song was, but they think it should be a tradition now. So I'm not sure what next year's is, but a couple more things. Our concert volunteers, Richard, Tim, Marta, all the music parent committee, there's so many. And who else, Mr. KP? Really? Okay, and then in order to actually set all this craziness up today, we had a ton of students. We had a ton of students that were actually like melting their brains out this afternoon, setting up and moving stuff, because it was stinking hot. I want to thank all those students, but also there's kind of four students that have especially been, what can we call them? I don't know. Like doing everything this year and helping with everything. So we had festival, we had all kinds of stuff. They were involved to the max, like as much as I was. Leonor and Aiden and Tessa and Ethan, where are you? Wait. Yay. They did tons this year. So thank you to them. I told them I owe them lunch and then I forgot. So I still have to buy them lunch at one of these times. Okay. And... because they were like, what is this? So we went on a trip a week and a bit ago, and on the trip they decided they need a new mascot. So we were at Coombs on the island, and there were a lot of stuffies, and I said, okay, you guys have to take pictures and vote. Tell me what you think we should get. So Chester the Chicken was one of ours. And then we have, I don't remember what his name is. We still have to find a good name for him, but we have this dude, Gorilla Guy. So these were the top choices, and they will apparently become our mascots now. Yes? Can we get an applause for those guys? No? Yeah, Chester the Chicken and our gorilla. And now, it's time. I told Mr. Kirkpatrick we'd be done this concert by 8:30, so we can do this. Mask a platoon. Crazy, right? Did they do it though? Yeah! Good job, you guys. All right. I don't know if Mr. Liversidge is out there to finish up our concert. I forgot to say one more big thank you. Thank you to George Eliot Secondary for coming and joining us as part of their trip. We went to see them last year, but it's great to have them here tonight. So thank you for being here and adding to the chaos. Thank you all. Thank you all for being here and all your support all year. Have a fantastic evening. Music Family Barbecue next Friday. These students are all going to stay and help clean up. If you want to help and get them out of here faster, feel free to help. Everything goes back. Thank you. Good night.
One more thing. You can help us out by picking up any garbage that you've left on the ground. That would help us huge. Thank you very much.